Hi, I'm Katherine Swanson, food safety consultant and ICMSF member since 2001. Have you ever wondered about appropriate tests to run on a food sample, how many tests to take? This presentation will help you find the answers to that question. First, let's look at the difference between within-lot testing and between-lot testing. The ICMSF video on microbiological testing for process control discusses testing that can occur within a manufacturing factory. Such testing should be based on detailed knowledge of the process and the product. Between-lot testing is useful in a manufacturing facility to evaluate variation between different lots and to verify that processes and practices are performed as intended. Conversely, within-lot testing is used to establish the safety or quality of a specified lot of food, such as testing food products at the port of entry or testing ingredients upon receipt at the manufacturer. In these situations, frequently there's little or no knowledge of the processing conditions used to produce the lot. Examples of within-lot sampling plans do exist for certain food products. The ICMSF book, Microorganisms in Foods 8, has recommended sampling plans for a wide variety of food products. These represent within-lot testing recommendations when production conditions and history are not known, such as for incoming ingredients or port of entry inspections. This book also recommends between-lot testing and suggests that the within-lot sampling plans would apply when in-process or other testing indicates a potential for contamination. For example, detection of a pathogen in environmental samples or elevated counts for indicators in line samples may trigger end-product testing. This example from Microorganisms in Foods 8 for dried breakfast cereal illustrates the concepts discussed. If confidence in the supplier is low, within-lot testing for certain ingredients is recommended. For example, mycotoxin testing of raw grains and salmonella testing for sensitive ingredients such as nuts and cocoa may be appropriate in a cereal example. In-process and environmental testing are highly recommended for cereal products to verify that the process and operating conditions are implemented as intended. End-product testing for indicators is recommended to allow for trend analysis of process control and the potential for recontamination. The utility of doing this testing is maximized when results are compared between lots in a factory. However, at port of entry or for an incoming ingredient, this is typically available on a lot-by-lot basis. In this example, 5 samples N are tested. No result can exceed 100 per gram or big M. If more than 2 of the samples C had Enterobacteriaceae counts between 10 little m and 100 big M, the lot is also unacceptable. Note that the testing for pathogens is recommended during normal operation when effective, good hygienic practices and HACCP are confirmed by tests recommended on this and the previous slide. However, if other testing indicates a potential safety issue, then within-lot testing for salmonella is recommended. Of course, at port of entry or for incoming ingredients, this sampling would apply. For food manufacturers, government entities, and receiving customers do not have limitless resources for microbiological testing. Thus, they need to focus resources on the most important tests. ICMSF recommends tests that provide the most useful information to evaluate the microbiological status of a product. For example, aerobic colony counts in generic E. coli were deemed useful for raw meat products. However, for ground meat that is raw, testing shifted to generic E. coli and E. coli 0157. Conversely, no routine microbiological testing was recommended for cured meat products, while for cooked meat products, aerobic colony counts, generic E. coli, salmonella, Staphylococcus aureus, Clostridium perfringens, and Listeria monocytogenes were deemed appropriate. This reference also considers that may considerations that may influence application of these tests. It also provides sampling plans similar to those in the serial example. Keep in mind that the relative importance of a test must be evaluated in the context of microbiological testing program. For example, if ingredient, in-process, and environmental monitoring are routinely conducted in a diligent manner, a stable processing environment, and the information is routinely used for trend analysis and process improvement, then the relative importance of finished product testing is likely to be low. However, if upstream testing is done only occasionally or in a manner that does not provide confidence that the process is under control, then the relative importance of the finished product sampling may go up. In conclusion, the relative importance of microbiological testing of food lots depends to a great extent on how much is known about how the product is manufactured. For example, at port of entry or for new ingredients, little may be known about how the food was manufactured, thus finished product testing may be important for sensitive products. However, when there is knowledge of how the food is processed, directing resources to test in other areas, such as environmental monitoring, ingredients, and in-process, may provide more useful information to ensure product safety. ICMSF's book, Microorganisms in Foods 8, use of data for process control and product acceptance, provides microbiological testing recommendations for 19 food product types. Please visit the ICMSF website for the latest information on ICMSF books and publications that can help you decide appropriate testing for your specific situation.